Last night while they were shaving my head, Yona's recording and goes, guys, everyone on three, Finkumentary. So we have good footage of that.
Could we do it on three, Finkumentary right now?
Guys, everyone on three, Finkumentary. Three, two, one.
Finkumentary!
Jacob's a bit excited about seeing the otters.
Otters are incredibly cool.
It would appear that Jacob Fink, for once, has made a positive comment.
There we go. I make positive comments all the time.
No, you don't.
The majority of my comments are positive.
You're a negative Nancy.
No.
Jacob, would you like to say a few words about the panda?
You guys all know about 1838.
Fink, would you like to say a few words about the elephant?
Stop filming me.
Jacob's first argument with his new friend, Noah Klein.
I've known him for a while, but...
Oh, now you're lying in the documentary. Thank you, Jacob. Jacob and his friends have seemed to have gotten lost. The National Zoo in Washington, D.C. Jacob's pretty disappointed right now that he gets any of the animals.
Rusty the panda.
Wasn't coming out, and he doesn't want...
Big disappointment today. Apparently, two of the pandas had... were not outdoors today and are now indoors.
Oh, Jacob has a question.
I have a major question. Why are you making a documentary?
Because your life is so interesting.
Why do we need to make a documentary about you? Do you not understand the importance of preserving these years? Think... We care about you. We want to preserve your memory forever.
I love you, Benjamin. I love you.
The group dynamic is being messed with as Klein and Yona get in their second argument of the evening about whether Rusty ran away or not, which Jacob's clear answer is, say yes, Jacob. Say yes, Jacob. Jacob, just say yes.
Klein believes,
just say yes.
I'm explaining the actual argument. Klein believes that Rusty killed somebody.
Oh.
While Yona says that Rusty merely ran away.
Oh, okay.
Yona's correct.
All right, great. Thank you for your input, Jacob. Have a nice day.
How does Jacob Fink act around his friends?
He's a very weird person. Seems uncomfortable sometimes.
Where are we right now?
We're in the National Zoo in Washington, D.C., where Jacob Fink is getting lost finding a bathroom. As you see right there, he's just bumped into some tourists.
Is he enjoying his trip?
I have no idea.
Is it true that you sat next to him on the bus ride?
For half of it. He's a big seat hogger.
All right, and... I think that's enough questions for right now.
I don't think those are words.
They are.
Zech.
Zech.
What the hell?
that would be a...
Like, you have to send it to me before you upload it anyway.
No. First, I'll upload it to the
podcast. There's only 5 people are going to see it.
I'm just saying.
Well, then I can upload it other places.
I get final cut.
I would like to see it in Gesher 13.
No.
That's the goal.
That's the only way that happens if I get final cut.
You will get final cut.
But for no, first the uncut version in...
The title. That's what it can be, Grant. The title.
Can I have a chat with the cameraman?
Of course.
This is most definitely harassment.
This is the whole video.
This is also, like, great... cinema.
It's the entire, like, this entire film is a form. Why are you. This entire film is a form of harassment.
Probably on my part, but not on your friend's part.
No, on their part, yeah.
I mean, I could probably get fired for this, but.
Whatever.
Can't offer, like,
wait,
camera.
I actually see the camera right now. Still, why? Heller's not blocking anything.
Scorsese did this, Spielberg did this, and now me. Here's our director, Yona Kornsgold.
On a beautiful, beautiful camera.
This water bottle.
Mr. Zipkowitz, what was the inspiration behind this this film?
Well, Jacob Fink actually told me a few weeks ago that
Jacob Fink did not.
He
tell
wanted
you
us to document
this.
His summer.
That
so
is not true.
So in 10 years, he
Zippy
could
is
watch
lying.
It and remember and be nostalgic about it.
So this is really like
Zippy
a
Zippy is lying.
Community service kind of thing.
Yeah,
this Zippy is.
You should really be thanking me. At this
Zippy
point.
Is blatantly lying.
Sundance Film Festival, here we come.
Gideon, this secret recording is not really working because I've caught you almost every time.
Gideon,
I'm gonna buy you a camera hat.
If you do that, I'd be very happy.
Get like a pair of sunglasses with
a camera. We should record Fink sleeping like a Paranormal Activity.
Yeah, we're gonna record Fink sleeping.
No, you are not. That is not happening.
Also, Fink eating dinner.
I'm too big for it.
I'm too small. Perfect size.
I don't know. I'm leg lifting.
I don't. I'm perfect size.
As you saw, I can't reach
it. If you ever need to.
That was last summer.
That was last summer.
He goes into them. Sundance Film Festival, here we come.
Our cinematographer, Ethan Smith. Ethan, how have you approached getting the angles and the shots for this film?
How have I what?
And we have Fink's reaction.
Our sound man, Aaron Afrin, also responsible for makeup. Even though this is a documentary, so you don't need that much makeup, but let's
You need makeup. You really do need makeup. Was there a question?
No. Now let's get some shots of scenery to put in random parts of the film.
Condom alarm!
I'm trying to not...
Condom! Used condom! Alec!
He has no knowledge of this experience. No knowledge of the playing of the language. Playing Caddy Cake.
Talking about Kashrut, of course, as always. As Fink likes to do, he likes to discuss the Kashrut rules of Judaism.
He has no idea.
No idea. Talking about what group. Zippy doing a great job of blocking the camera. No! Oh, that. I thought you meant something else.
And we leave Jacob Fink alone, contemplating on the bench.
So over here we have Mr. Fink and Mr. Zipkowitz. They were clearly playing geography together for a long time on this bus ride.
Wait, before we begin,
it appears. What was happening, Daniel? What was happening during this proceedings, Mr. Zipkowitz? Please explain what has happened. Excuse me.
I'm explaining.
Yes.
We have been playing the game for.
Please look at the camera. Thank you. Smile.
Probably about 2 hours, and it was getting kind of hard to find.
Actually, look at the camera.
Oh, sorry. So Jacob thought it would be a good idea to steal my phone for a bit. Start looking up like places that had A's in as the first letter to try and
okay.
win the game.
So I have a question for you. Excuse me, it's not your turn to speak yet. Excuse me, you do not have the conch. Okay, now, Daniel, how did that make you feel?
Oh, it made me upset, you know?
Were you personally offended?
I was offended. I was upset that one of my friends would do that to me.
You shed a tear.
I mean,
did anybody ask you?
I'm just explaining.
Nobody asked you.
May I say myself?
Can I ask you a question? Did anybody ask you?
Yes. You're cheating. In fact, I asked myself. May I?
That sounds creepy to me.
May I?
Okay.
May I interject?
Is it your turn to speak?
We haven't been allowed you to speak yet, okay?
Okay.
Now, why do you think he's trying to overcompensate for his clear lack of knowledge of geography?
What happened was a few nights ago in the bunk we were studying vocab for the SATs. And it turns out Jacob knew like 1 out of 50 words.
Also not true.
And I would just get them one after the other. And Jacob gets really mad. He throws all his stuff on the floor. His towels,
also
shower equipment.
Sport, he wears this blue shirt. Uncustomized.
Not this blue shirt. Oh, on Yom Sport, correct. I did not hear it again.
Well,
we can
also,
stop recording.
We have this black fan which is identical to the one Mr. Smith has in his area. As you can see, the Wild Fink loves the Mets and decides to show his tribute by getting a Mets pillow. We also have a Mets towel.
Blanket.
Hardcore shit.
Blanket.
I don't give a shit.
Really?
Alright, I'm a British National Geographic person. I studied in Harvard for 4 years, so it doesn't really matter. And this is his comforter, which is blue. Doesn't have anything to do with the Mets except for the fact that it's probably blue. And this is light blue, so it doesn't do anything with the Mets. So you could say that the Wild Fink has maybe a 75% tribute to the Mets in his life. And that's all I have to say. This is BBC going out. Up next is Walter Cronkite, his ghost, of course, because he's dead.
Thank you. One, two, three, ho! Get yourself together and drive your funky soul. They're doing it.